हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस कंडक्ट अवर टुडेज एक्सपेरिमेंट दैट इज सिग्नल जनरेटर. एज यू कैन सी इट्स डिजाइन इट्स एम डिजाइन एंड रियलाइज एंड ऑप एम्प बेस्ड फंक्शन जनरेटर टू जनरेट अ स्क्वायर वेव एंड अ ट्रायंगुलर वेव ऑफ डिजायर्ड फ्रीक्वेंसी. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद स्क्वायर वेव फर्स्ट. दैट इज स्क्वायर वेव जनरेटर एंड लेटर विल गो फॉर ट्रायंगुलर wave generator. Now to have this circuit, we require following apparatus: 741 IC, resistors, capacitors, regulated power supply, CRO and breadboard. So following the theory and procedure, you have to build this circuit on breadboard. One op amp, 741 op amp, one capacitor, RF equal to 10 kilo ohm, R2 equal to 12 kilo ohm, R1 equal to 10 kilo ohm. Now, to get this values, you should have this following design. So here the design is not very complicated. As you can see, one simple formula you have to use here for square wave generator with the 741 op amp. That is capital T time period is equal to 2 of RF feedback resistor, C stands for capacitance, ln of 2 R2 plus R1 whole divided by R2. So if you substitute this, and there is a one more assumption, that is R2 equal to 1.16 times of R. Now if we assume R2 equal to 1.16 times of R1, then we will reach for this equation. It is capital T equal to 2 RF into C. Now here you have to assume the value for C to find RF, and also R1 you have to assume to find the value of R2. So with one example we have done it here. That is, let us assume frequency to be of 2 kilohertz. With this frequency, the time period will be 2 milliseconds, and we have also assumed capacitance to be equal to 0.1 microfarad. So this gives us RF equal to, if we substitute this frequency, this time period in, and this capacitance into this T equal to 2 RF by C, this will give you RF equal to 10 kilo ohm. So let us choose this 10 kilo ohm as standard value, and assume R1 equal to 10 kilo ohm. Then considering this assumption, if you substitute, you will get R2 equal to 12 kilo ohm standard value. So we will get these values. That is, we have assumed capacitance equal to 0.1 microfarad, 10 kilo ohm we have got as per our design, and 12 kilo ohm as per our design, and we have assumed R1 equal to 10 kilo ohm. Let us see on our breadboard how it works. Yes, this is your circuit on this breadboard. I'll just show you. This is our 741 IC, 741 op amp. Capacitance 0.1 microfarad. You can see it. It's 104. So 104 is our 0.1 microfarad, and this is your feedback resistor, 10 kilo ohm, and this is your R1, 10 kilo ohm, and this one, orange, red, brown, this is your 12 kilo ohm R2, and we have done the remaining connections. That is, we have given plus VCC and minus VCC, plus 12 volt and minus 12 volt, minus 12 volt here at pin number 4. And pin number 7 is fed with plus 12. So the output is taken here to the CRO. You can see
I'll try to stop this just to show you that I kept my dial at time period at 1. You can see here, this one, it is kept at 1 so that I can easily multiply it with 1. Yes, now you can see it is completely covering one complete cycle, is occupying two divisions from here to here and here to here. One division and two divisions. These two divisions multiplied by one. So 2 into 1 is 2, 2 milliseconds. So this gives us
now let us understand how to generate triangular wave generator. Here, this is our main circuit which will produce triangular wave. But for this triangular wave generation, to get this output, we require a square wave input for this. Now, we have already designed a square wave generator. Same square wave generator output can be fed to your integrator circuit like this. Okay, this is same circuit with 0.1 microfarad, 10K, 12K and 10K. This design we have just seen now. And same output, if it is fed to this circuit, it will give you triangular wave output. Now, the design for this circuit, we'll see it here. Take RF CF grid. It should be much greater than time period. This is your RF and CF. Okay. To keep it much greater than the product of these two, let us take equal to 10 times of time period. Time period, we have already designed this square wave generator with a time period of 2 milliseconds, right? 2 milliseconds. When with that 2 milliseconds, let us assume CF equal to 0.01 microfarad and let us find RF. So if we substitute in this equation, we will get RF 10T divided by C. T is here 2 millisecond, capacitance 0.1 micro, so it will give you 2 mega ohms. So with this resistance 2 mega ohm CF and R1, the input side resistance, we take 1/10 of feedback resistance, that is 200 kilo ohm. 2 mega divided by 10 will give you 200 kilo ohm. Now let us see in our circuit. Yes, this is your circuit. This is your square wave generator, your first circuit, and this is your second circuit. The output of this square wave is fed to this second circuit, second op amp. Okay. So here you can see resistance, capacitance I have connected as per our design. 2 mega ohm. Since I was not having 2 mega ohm, I have connected 1 mega ohm and 1 mega ohm in series so as to add and make it 2 mega ohm. Okay. Let us see its output. You can see, yes, this is your triangular wave output. You can clearly see there, triangular wave is having a time period of 2 milliseconds. That is, it is covering one division here, and this one into this time scale, that is, it is kept at 2, it is kept at 2 millisecond. 2 into 1 becomes 2 millisecond. So we are getting a triangular wave with a time period of 2 millisecond with this present design, with this present design and this circuit. Okay. So this will end here. this experiment of square wave generation and triangular wave generation. So with this, square wave generation is giving us this waveform. The time period is of 2 milliseconds. And I have plot triangular wave for this. So both have same time period. Within the same time period, for this square wave, it is converting into triangular wave with this circuit. Okay? Yes, thank you.
Both outputs simultaneously, you can see here. If you measure its time period, it's coming out to be 2 milliseconds for both the waveforms. Okay? Thank you.